the edge. In a small workshop, two brothers were working on a strange machine. It didn't look like much. Just bits of wood, cloth, and wire all tied together. Townsfolk nearby laughed. A flying machine? Ha! Impossible. Not in a million years, it was a skid. But the brothers didn't listen. They tinkered and tested, fixing every wobble and every crash, until on one cold, windy day, their machine lifted off the ground. For 12 glorious seconds it soared, and the sky was never the same again. Great change in history begins just like that, with someone daring to dream what others call impossible. And these dreams are what I call rebel ideas. And it wasn't just the brothers who experienced something similar. Martin Luther King Jr., who dreamt of equality and civil rights, was told countless times that his dream was unrealistic. Even Albert Einstein, when he first proposed his theory of relativity, he was initially viewed with doubt. Yet here we are, soaring through the skies, breaking down barriers, and exploring our universe's secrets. Rebel ideas built the world we live in today. But what exactly are rebel ideas? Well, rebel ideas isn't about being different just for the sake of it. It's about challenging assumptions, questioning past doubts, and uncovering new possibilities. These ideas are the ones that transform our future. They make us uncomfortable. They force us to ask, why not? Yet most of us are taught to play it safe. From classrooms to boardrooms, the world rewards the safe answer, not the bold one. That's why these ideas are so rare and precious. But, of course, what are the benefits of these ideas? Well, first of all, they solve problems others overlook. Henry Ford once asked, why can't cars be affordable to everyone? His rebel idea? The assembly line. Today, cars are accessible to millions. And second of all, they give power to new voices. For centuries, breakthroughs were controlled by a select few who had access to resources and influence. But now, with digital tools and open platforms, anyone from teachers to students to even you can spark real change. And lastly, they inspire courage. Because when just one person stands up with a bold idea, it gives others permission to do the same. But let's be real, having rebel ideas isn't easy. People may laugh, criticize, or even call it naive. Take Nelson Mandela, sentenced to 24 years in prison for an idea. Rosa Parks, arrested because of a seat. Because the truth is that rebel ideas almost never win instantly. They win eventually, when the world finally catches up. So what's my call to you? I say that you should protect your rebel ideas. That strange thought you had in class, write it down. That wild solution to a problem, test it out. Or that just one question that nobody else dares to ask, be the one who asks it. Because the future doesn't need any more of the same. It needs people who are willing to bend the edges, push the line, and to rebel with purpose. Every breakthrough, every invention, and every movement that we now take for granted began as someone's rebel idea. So the next time your idea feels too different, too strange, or even too ambitious, always remember that the things the world view as impossible today might just be the thing the world needs next. My name is Mahadika. Thank you.